For the 41st time, the Retromobile in Paris opened the European classic car season and visitors came from all over the world. The first classics could be seen in the Parisian streets, while the big rarities are flaunting in the halls 1 and 2 of the fairgrounds at the Porte de Versailles. Almost 120,000 visitors strolled through the corridors at the fair, passing dealers, spare parts, automobilia and books. A few years ago, the Retromobile was considered more or less as a fair of classic thoroughbred cars, dedicated to the clubs of major French brands and an accordingly aligned spare parts market. The focus has changed in the last few years. The fair became international and the presentations of higher quality. Many prepared special themed displays pleased the visitors this year. And last but not least, the quality of the traded classic cars rose. Never before one could see as many high-quality Ferraris and racing vehicles from different brands as at this year's edition of the Retromobile. But also a clear trend can be recognized. Classic sports cars are in demand. If ever a sedan could be encountered, then please with a lot of horsepower under the hood. This trend is even reflected in the auction houses. Truly spoken, there was the one or other sedan at the Art Carriole, but all of them had a sporty or luxurious gene. Facel Vega, Ford Comet or sporty variants of the Della A from the 1950s. Pre-war models remained almost unnoticed, except these cars, where a Bugatti or Aston Martin badge graces the radiator grille. This development pleased the visitors. Awesome, with glazed eyes, they stand in front of the cars and marveling at the beauty of the legendary sports cars, knowing only from the coffee table books. Also, the international collector's elite is found on the Retromobile. Paris in these days, the place to be. Here, it's during these days trading and buying in a big way. The prices scare even insiders, and one wonders whether the call prices are probably the trend barometer for 2016. The stands of the dealers offered some real uniques. Of course, a racing legend of French automotive history may not be missing at the great show of the Car Nation, a Ferrari 275 GTB/2 adorned with a tricolore, or the Porsche 356 GTL Abarth from 1962 at the booth of Fiskens. On the same booth, the Pizzarini Competition or the elegant Alfa Romeo Competizione Coupé and the marvelous Alfa Romeo Tipo 33 Daytona Coupé. The market speaks a clear language. Everything is bought, which is fast. Right next to it, the Escuderia Montjuich Ferrari 512M in a very original condition. Terms like originality and patina were heard more this year than the last previous years, and more dealers showed appropriate vehicles at the booth. For example, a BMW 700 RS with two-cylinder boxer engine, the pre-war Aston Martin Roadster, a Mercedes-Benz 28/95 Phaeton from 1914 with a wooden body, the Porsche 904 at the booth of Alexander Schütte, or a very original Mercedes-Benz 300 SL at Movendi. Her car engineering presented a wonderful black gullwing pre-owned from New York with patina. Next to it, the prototype of the Mercedes-Benz 300 SL Roadster from 1955. Only 5 of the pre-series prototypes were ever built and were significantly different from the series vehicles. A course over the Retromobile brings new surprises around every corner. exhibition of the 110th anniversary of the birth of the ACO about the history of Le Mans cars. There was a rear Deutsch Bonnet, the Ferrari Dino Berlinetta prototype, or a solid Acton, Shannon and Walker from 1925. A highlight of this year's Retromobile was certainly the auction by Art Curiel, where the Ferrari 335S factory race car was auctioned with the incredible record price of over 32 million euros. He was of course putting some of the other highlights in the shade, as for example the Facel Vega Prototype 5 from 1954. This elegant icon of French automotive art scored after all just right with 500,000 euros. Also the Ferrari Testarossa Spider Valeo from 1986 scored a record price of 1.2 million euros. Also at Art Curiel, a tendency towards sporty vehicles was to be recognized. Pre-war vehicles could be found only on the edge. While many vehicles remained far behind the estimate price or were not sold, as also at the auction of Bonhams at the Grand Palais or the R.M. Sotheby's auction at the Champs-Élysées, the strong need of restoration-worthy and original vehicles was astonishing. The Alfa Romeo Giulia Sprint GTA, with significant traces of an accident from 1955, achieved about twice the estimate price of more than 440,000 euros. This was also a record sale. Art Curiel estimated even a world record. Over 45,000 euros were offered for the Alfa Romeo Giulietta Sprint, and the Lancia Flaminia Sport with a Zagato body even achieved 175,000 euros. But the seller withdrew the sale because the price was not high enough for him. A 1958 Fiat Abarth 750 GT Zagato barn find scored scarce 47,000 euro. Even lovers of automotive art shouldn't miss to come to the Retromobile. Through two long corridors, many artists and art galleries presented artistic photographs, sculptures, lithographs and graphics with a focus on classic cars. And who even couldn't find anything here might be going home with a small classic car from one of the booths with the miniature models. Our conclusion: the Retromobile opened the season with a bang.